Real wealth isn't about flashy cars. Yes, they're nice. Real wealth isn't about designer clothes or designer bags. Yes, they're nice. Real wealth is not even about having a big house. Let me tell you what real wealth is about. It's about what you can't see, what you can't really put a finger on, your savings, your investments, you being debt-free, your freedom, your peace of mind, the air that you get to breathe in different parts of the world. You see, real wealth brings something that the majority of people cannot see. What is that? Your time. I have a nice car. I have designer options. But one of the things that I did before I even got this stuff, y'all know I drove an Acura TL for years. I was making six figures, multiple six figures, and I drove that thing for years. Why? Because I wasn't a homeowner first. I drove that thing for years and lived in an apartment and rented an apartment for years. Why? Because I wanted to start investing. I wanted to position myself to where I could start buying back my time. Once I was positioned myself to where I was able to buy back my time, I got real estate, I'm investing, I'm building a business. Then yes, I went and got my dream car. I haven't purchased my dream home yet. Watch this. I'm sorry, I lied. I did purchase my dream home. A dream home for me is a home that I can afford. But when I say a dream home per y'all standards, it's that big, like, oh my gosh, this is gorgeous, right? I haven't done that yet. Why? Because one, I'm not married. And then two, I just haven't felt like I'm in a good position to do that just yet. My business and my studio needs some stuff to happen. I still need to hire some staff. I'm going to do it soon, right? But I had to make sure that I'm positioning myself well. And so I'm still somewhat acting below my wages, but I'm still somewhat acting broke. Why? Because I want to build true financial security, not just for myself, but I want financial security for my family, for my future family, for my staff, for my team members who are helping me build this amazing business. One of the things that I just despise is, like, when you see pastors looking nice, driving cars, living all this big stuff, and their core people are struggling and hurting. I don't want to be the boss to where I'm making all this money and I'm living my life and my staff, my team members are struggling. Can't live. I don't want that. So I got to make more money so I can pay them more and help them build. Now they got to work. They got to work for it, right? But one thing I learned from the millionaire next door, it highlights that most millionaires don't live in like these extremely upscale neighborhoods or these super, super expensive cars, right? Instead, most net worth millionaires practice being frugal and invest in appreciating assets rather than spending all their money on things that lose value. Why? Because these net worth millionaires understand that living below your means, living within your means, is the key to accumulating true wealth. I need y'all to hear me again. The key to accumulating true wealth, it's not looking like you have it. Because I know people right now who are driving Range Rovers, who are driving Bugattis. I know people right now who are driving Mercedes S-Classes, who are driving $100,000, $200,000cars. I know people right now who are wearing the $1,000, $1,200 wigs. I know people right now who have the $5,000 purse on their shoulder, and they are struggling. They are stressed. They do not have freedom. You at $55,000 a year have more freedom than some of these millionaires. As a matter of fact, did you know that nearly 52% of the people, 52% of the people who make above $100,000 or more a year are living paycheck to paycheck? You know why? Because they don't want to look broke. You know why? Because they are living way above their means. You know why? It's because they are afraid to tell themselves no today so they can tell themselves yes and yes and yes tomorrow. You see, by looking broke, you free up more money to put towards your savings and investments, just like the net worth millionaires inside of the book. This gives you a safety net that many people who look rich simply do not have. Yeah, they got the big house, but they also got a big payment with that house. Yeah, they got the nice car, but yes, they have the nice car with that house. If I had to shut my business down today, I don't have to sell my car. It's paid for. What's going on, family? It's your boy, Anthony ONeal. And I want to share a secret with you. I want to share something with you that I regret not doing sooner. If you've been thinking about getting life insurance, now is the time to act. Let me tell you about my friends over at Ethos, a life insurance company that's making waves with its affordability and ease of access. You can get coverage for as low as $30 a month. My own rate was just around $60 a month. And I spend more than that on food delivery. Let me be honest. I'm going to give you some quick points of why I love them so much. Number one is their rates and affordability. Imagine paying $30 or $68 a month for a peace of mind. That's less than most of your monthly subscriptions. Number two, ease of use. You can get up to $2 million in coverage without any medical exams or blood tests. Just answer a few quick, healthy questions and you're set. The entire process is 100% online and take less than 10 minutes. Number three, speed. You can get a quote in seconds. You can apply in minutes and have same day coverage. I got my coverage through Ethos literally in 10 minutes and got my thing back quick. Trust and reliability is the last thing I love about them. Ethos has an A+ rating with the BBB and stellar Trustpilot reviews. Every day, around 2,000 families are approved for life insurance through Ethos. Listen, I don't want you to wait. Life insurance rates can increase by 8 to 10% each year you delay. I purchased my policy a few years ago, and if I had waited until now, my price would be significantly higher. Lock in your rate right now and secure your family's future. I want you to visit anthonyoneal.com/ethos to get your free life insurance quote. Apply and get coverage in under 10 minutes. Don't procrastinate. Take control of your future today. You see, what we see is a lot of them may have expensive stuff, but behind the scenes, they're often drowning in debt. Anthony ONeal has the pink slip to the car. I got the deed to the car. I got the deed to my watch. I got the deeds to everything but my mortgage. And meanwhile, while they're over there stressing, while they're over there trying to figure out what to do and how to do things, you're quietly building wealth. While so many people may be looking at you like, man, why are you driving that car? You're quietly building wealth and paying off your debt. Why are you watching all these other families? Oh, this is good. Going on these big old family vacations. And you and your son, and you and your family are doing staycations. You're creating true financial freedom for you and yourself and your family. You know, I was doing some research and I realized, I really want to break this down because I was doing some research. The average millionaire has roughly 50 to 60% of their net worth invested inside of stocks, bonds, mutual funds, and retirement accounts. Stocks, bonds, mutual funds, and retirement accounts. But whoa, you said 50 to 60% of their net worth is invested inside of stocks, bonds, mutual funds, and retirement accounts? That's a whole lot of money. Let me break this down for you. This simply means that if a millionaire has a net worth of $1 million, this means that they might have around $500,000 to $600,000 actively invested in various financial instruments. But wait a minute, Anthony. You mean they put $500,000? No. They probably put about $200,000 of their money over a long period of time, and that $200,000 turned into $500,000 or $600,000. It's the power of compound interest. It's the power of using a mutual fund, ETFs, getting into the stock market. Now, why they have $500,000 to $600,000 actively cash invested through their money and through the power of compound interest, the remaining part of their net worth could be tied up in real estate, business ownership like myself, or other assets that generate income or appreciate over time. This, and I won't say balanced approach, this juggling approach allows net worth millionaires to grow their wealth steadily while maintaining financial security.